The last two parashiyot dealt with the rebellion of the Jewish people against Egypt and the successful exit of the Jews from Egypt. What is fascinating about Parashat Yitro is that when Yitro sees this kind of successful rebellion, he doesn't praise the Jews, and he doesn't praise Moses. He praises God. And this is exceedingly significant. It's even more significant because it's not only Yitro who does this, the Torah does this. Because it's God who says, I shall take them out. I shall redeem them. I shall save them. It's God who is the Savior in this particular revolt. And let me explain why this idea is such an important idea. A very good friend of mine, Lanya Shapiro, Zecher Livracha, was a professor of history and wrote a magnificent book on revolutions. And he says that all the revolutions that he knows of have failed. Failed in the sense that the people who waged the revolution against the cruelty of the former rulers, when they became rulers in turn, having won the revolution, they were even more cruel than the people against whom they rebelled. Fascinating statement. I can give you two very clear examples. In 1789, the French Revolution, and those who won the French Revolution were even worse Rodanim, tyrants, than the people against whom they rebelled. And of course, the Communist Revolution. Certainly true of Stalin. He was a madman and a murderer in cold blood. And the Communist Revolution, those who won, were much worse than the czars against whom they rebelled. It's even true in South Africa today. The whites were cruel rulers. But the blacks are no less corrupt and no less cruel in their way today after they won. So they didn't really win. Because if the winners of the revolution accept the humanity, or rather inhumanity, of the people against whom they rebelled, then they lost that revolution. I say this because of a very worrying phenomenon which is taking place today in certain outposts of the Shomron, Rechelim, where there is suspicion of Jewish terror. And even yeshiva students throwing stones at Arab cars. I believe that this entire phenomenon is based on a very wrong ideal. One word. If we understand, as the Torah understood and as Yitro understood, that God won the war against Egypt, and then we also understand that that God taught us that every human being, even the Egyptians, even the Palestinians, are created in God's image, then there is no qualitative difference between Jew and Gentile. And then we can never treat the Gentiles the way they treated us. We dare never harm an innocent Gentile. And I can tell you, as the Rav of Efrat, there have been a number of times when the Palestinians who live near us have literally saved our lives against attacks from other Palestinians. We dare not lift a stone against an innocent Palestinian. Then we've lost our rebellion. The most important principle in the Torah is Vayivra Elokim et Adam b'Tzalmo. God created every human being in his image. There is no qualitative difference between Jew and Gentile. Rav Kook learns this from an amazing Talmudic statement in Masechet Sanhedrin, that a Gentile who studies Torah can be as great as a high priest. There's a special segula to being Jewish, generations of Mesirat Hashem and morality. We have a special mission to teach morality. But qualitatively, we have to make certain that we see every human being B'Tzelem Elokim, and we never throw stones against an innocent Gentile who hasn't been proven to be a murderer. Shabbat Shalom.